It's the moment you've all been waiting for. You can now develop with Azure SQL Database for free. Yes, you heard that correctly. Free, forever, serverless. Come check it out this week on Data Exposed. Hi, I'm Anna Hoffman, and welcome to this episode of Data Exposed. Today, I'm joined by Nils. Nils, thanks so much for joining us on Data Exposed. We have a really exciting episode, but first, I want to hear a little bit about you and what you do.
Thanks, Anna. It's great to be here on Data Exposed. I've been a PM at Microsoft since 1996, and I've worked on many different product teams. Pretty much everything I've worked on has been data-related. I've done some big data projects with Bing, built an A-B testing experimentation platform for Microsoft that's used for thousands of experiments a year. That was built on Azure SQL Database. And more recently, I was part of the Azure Machine Learning platform. And about 6 months ago, I joined the Azure Data Org. It's an exciting time as we're building the data platform in the cloud for the era of AI.
Awesome. Well, it's great to have you on the show. I'm actually so excited. I'm trying not to, spill the beans right now. So like, tell us what you have to tell us today.
Yeah. So my first project in Azure Data has been to look at how customers are getting started with Azure SQL Database. One of the things that I learned from customers was that they wanted to try the product, but it wasn't necessarily easy to try for free. So we recently announced a public preview of a new free offer for Azure SQL Database that we're really excited about. And I'd like to show you that and show you how you can get started with it.
Absolutely. I mean, this is just so exciting. This has been something people have been asking me personally about for years. And I'm sure everyone's been wondering why it doesn't exist. Tell us more about it.
Sure. So let's start on azure.com, which is one of the ways that you can find the offer. And there are many free offers for Azure services. Some have time limits and some are free always. So one of the things you'll notice here, and I'll just pause for a second, is there's a new Azure SQL Database free offer tile that you'll see right on the top here. And this is now in the free always category. So the previous offer had a 12-month limit. We've updated that. To get started, head on over to the Azure SQL Database page, and you'll see a banner there, and it's advertising this new free offer. From there, you can click through, and you can see the learn documentation. We've got details on how to get started. And everything you're going to want to know about this this awesome new offer. So to summarize the offer, this is a general purpose serverless database offer. So this is the same general purpose serverless database you would get, but it has a free amount of 100,000 vCore seconds per month and 32 gigabytes of storage and backup storage. So as I mentioned, there's no time limit on this offer. The database is good for the lifetime of the subscription. You do, however, only get one database per subscription. So if you want to start over, then you have to remove the one you have, but you get one database per subscription.
Awesome. Cool. So now that we kind of understand the offer, can you show us like, how do I deploy it? How's it different? What's it look like?
Yeah, let's head on over to the portal.azure.com. And the first thing you're going to want to do is create a SQL database resource. There's a few different ways to get to that. But you get to this creation page, and I'll pause here for a second. So the offer is right there on top of the page with the pink banner. And you're just going to want to hit apply offer on that. And you will see that the offer has been applied. Once you have the cost card over on the right, you'll see it's zero charges. And so then you go ahead and all you have to do is the usual set up the database name. And then you've got a choice here. And this is sort of a key part of the offer, which is, do you want the database to pause when it's done with the free amount. So that means you're never going to have any charges. Or if you reach those limits, do you want to continue using the database for additional charges? So this is a key part of like how you can both use this database to develop, and then when you're ready to scale it up to a larger database, you switch to this continue usage mode. So we'll go ahead and continue on that. And so the, you know, one of the things that I like to do when I'm playing around with this offer here is you can also throw in a sample database. So the AdventureWorks is a great way to start, especially if you're learning SQL and you need something to build off of. So that's all you have to do to get started. Go ahead and add it in through the portal.
Awesome, cool. Now I know the question everyone's gonna ask is like, I saw on your screen, it said Azure SQL Database, general purpose serverless tier. So it's a general purpose serverless database, but how's it different from other Azure SQL databases?
Yeah, let's take a look at that. It's essentially the same as general purpose serverless tier. There's a few new features, and then there's a few features disabled. So the new features that you'll see when you go into the overview page is you'll see it's labeled under the pricing tier. It says free. You'll also see that now that there's a free monthly vCore amount. So this is how you keep track of how much you've used of the offer. Now, this is a new database, so there's nothing showing here yet. This is also the new metric that you can use to create alerts on too. So if you want to keep track of your vCore seconds, and get alerts as you're running out of them. That's something you can do there too. Let's continue to take a look at the page. So on the compute and storage options, you're going to see that that setting there on do you want it to auto pause or continue usage, and you can change that. But when you're on auto pause, you can go up to 4B database is going to be 32 gig. There's also a few options that were, I'll pause here for a second. There are a few options that were disabled at the bottom there, which is the your backup options are going to be in local mode on this. And you also, you can't create an elastic pool. You don't have auto failover. These are basically all sorts of options that if you're trying to conserve vCore seconds for what is primarily a development database, you don't actually want to have those enabled either. But let's say that you've used this as a development database, and now you want to start scaling up to have a production database. So, you know, when we change that option to continue usage, so now you can go all the way up to 80 vCores. So the same as you could with a general purpose production database. I'm not showing it here, but you can also go up to the 4 terabytes in size. You can change those backup redundancy options. And the charges that you'll get are the same as you would for a general purpose a database. So this is a great way to start out with a general purpose database, because you're going to get that free amount, and you're going to get that free amount every month.
Awesome. Cool. So how much do I really get in a month? Like, I think you said 100,000 vCore seconds. What does that mean? What can I do?
Yeah. So just one more thing I'll note is that you can also move out of this offer if you want to. You can turn it off, and then you can then move to a whole different service tier if you want to, because we really want to create a free offer where you can scale up and build on this. But yeah, let's take a look at what can you get for 100,000 vCore seconds. And the short answer is it's going to depend on how often you're using the database. Because it is a pausing serverless database, you could use it a little bit every day of the week and still be able to use this every day of the month, or you could choose to go with more vCores and do a more intense job in a shorter period of time. So you have this sort of ability to set that combination.
Awesome. Cool. Okay. So then what sort of tools come integrated with the free database?
Yeah. So the first thing I want to show here is you want to sort of start enabling this ecosystem of tools that we have. So you got to first do some security changes because the database does come locked down by default. You want to allow other Azure services access to this database. That's a key setting. And then once you've done that, then you're ready to start taking a look at that database with one of the tools I like to use is Azure Data Studio. And so let's go ahead and take a look at that. So Azure Data Studio, you just moving ahead here, you will just head on down to the getting started Azure Data Studio. Go ahead and click to open that up, and it's going to connect your write up. Put in some credentials, and now you've got a rich authoring environment. So, moving forward, so this in Azure Data Studio, we can take a look at those tables that were auto-created with that sample, all the standard functionality you would expect. But let's say that you're just going to start building off of this sample, and what you really want to do is your VentureWorks, the cycle company, is the example here. And you want to add in a new column. Let's say that you're not that great at writing SQL like me. And so one of the things I really like to do is I use the GitHub Copilot for SQL. And there's actually a free trial for that too. And so with GitHub Copilot in Azure Data Studio, all you have to do is start giving it some comments, and it'll start giving you ideas on what you need to do in terms of the SQL that you need to write. And it's kind of fun to play with. It gives you all sorts of interesting suggestions. If you're like me and you're slow at typing too, you're gonna get some interesting responses. But here we're just trying to add in a new column called ski length. And so it's gonna give some advice on the sort of the size of that field. And so we'll go ahead and do that. And then what'll happen with GitHub Copilot is it'll start writing the SQL for you. And so now it's gonna tell me that I need to alter that table, add in that column, and then I just run that command. And then I go over and take a look at my columns, and boom, I've added in a new column.
Nice.
All sorts of things that GitHub Copilot can help you with on your free database.
Awesome. Okay. So we've kind of seen like how to get this thing enabled, how to get started, how to get connected. Now start brainstorming with me, like what sorts of applications can you create with the free offer?
Yeah. So one of the great ways to get started with building an app on top of your database is Power Apps. And that too is built in right there in the portal for SQL Database. So you go down to Power Apps and go ahead and click Get Started. And it's going to actually help you just sort of right off pick one of the tables that you want to work with. And so we're going to work with that product table that we did with the free database. And so then you're going to jump over to the Power App, and I fast forwarded a little bit here, but the Power App has connected up to our free database. And let's say you're AdventureWorks and you want to create a mobile app that's going to let you put in information on the inventory there. So the amazing thing about this Power App is that it's going to give you a browse screen, a detail screen, and an edit screen. So let's go ahead and take a look at that. So here's the browse screen. So you can see the contents of your database. And here's the the edit screen where you can go ahead and add new things in. But we've got that new column that we added into the database, ski length. And so we're going to go ahead and add in that new field from our free database. And there it is right there. And just with a few clicks, you know, now we have an app that has been built, and go ahead and preview it. And it's got that new field from the database right off there.
Awesome.
Yeah, and so now that we've got some data in our database, and one other integration that I wanted to show is the Power BI integration. So right there by the Power Apps. So Power BI is going to help you create reporting on top of that free database. So so you go ahead and click on that, and then your Power BI desktop will open up, and we'll fast forward here, and we'll see that the it's going to connect right up to your free database, and then you're going to get to choose what you want to build your reporting on. So, you know, same great experience as Power Apps. You just go find that product table that we did some work on. You can preview it, and then we go ahead and we're going to select that table, put it into our reporting, and go ahead and load that in. And then you'll see that, you know, with this really nice integration with Power BI, you'll see that that table and those columns appear over on the side. So to add that new field and new column in to our report, we've got a, you know, simple table report we're going to add here. We just sort of click and add in a few different fields, and we'll throw that ski length column in there. And, you know, and then this is an environment where you can just start to build out really rich reports. This is a very simple report. I just wanted to show you how easy it is to create a database, try a free database, create an app on it, add data, and then build reports on it.
Awesome. Cool. Nils, I learned so much in this episode, and I think the most exciting thing is that you can now develop with Azure SQL Database for free. Get started with a couple clicks. You get all the features you know and love related to Azure SQL Database, especially that you need for developing your apps. And you even showed us some cool ways that you can get really easily connected to Azure Data Studio from the portal, really easily connected to Power BI, really easily connected to Power Apps. I'm super excited about this offer. I know a lot of our users will be as well. So to our viewers, go check this out. Go to the links here. We'll put them in the description for you to learn more. Like this episode if you're excited about this free offer. Leave us a comment and let us know how long you've been waiting for it. No, I'm just kidding. But leave us a comment and let us know what you think. And we hope to see you next time on Data Exposed.